Do alien civilization exist? Are they already on their way to meet us? And what can we do about it? Kurzgesagt recently made a video on the topic and we are going to watch and react to it together. Why, you may ask? Well, my name is Laure, I come from Switzerland, I'm a physicist, the weather is not great outside, so I thought it might be fun to hang out and watch of Kurzgesagt's videos.
Where is everyone else? The answer to this riddle could be as exciting as it is creepy. We are early, born before almost all other life. But very soon, this may change. An irreversible competition for the universe might be about to begin. While this video is based on scientific papers, we're presenting interesting ideas based on little data and lots of extrapolation. So take them with a grain of salt.
I really love the production quality of every single Kurzgesagt video. They said in one of them that they spent over 1,200 hours total, everybody working together to make just one 10 to 15 minutes videos. It's also great that they explain and show us that a lot of what they are going to talk in this video is completely speculative because we don't know the future, and as humans, we are generally bad at predicting it.
One, how fast can bacteria build spaceships? To become a star-faring civilization, life as we know it needs to master a number of very hard steps. It starts with dead stuff turning into the building blocks of life. Then it needs to organize into self-contained cells. Those cells have to learn to work together to form multicellular organisms. This keeps going until complex creatures with big brains learn to use tools and language. Civilization has to be formed from cultures that value progress and technological development.
I really appreciate this description of evolution, because it's true that evolution has to take all the steps from having a few materials to having actual civilization and cultures building things and working together. I really love the fact that they are explaining all of these jumps, because evolution is not linear. You don't have a slow and steady progression from one type of skills to another. You usually have some kind of huge jump when something amazing is invented, like the thumbs that let us use tools or eyes. Like, did you know that all the eyes from all the living creatures come from the same organism? Organism? Like, just at some point in our past, one cell became photosensitive, and it was such an amazing finding that everybody basically descends from that one type of cell.
And it's likely that, on trillions of planets, life has been trying for billions of years. Since we don't see any other technological civilizations out there, it might well be that we are a rare exception. We might be among the first, or even the first, technological civilization in the Milky Way. Why does humanity exist now? The universe is already 13.8 billion years old, but it's unlikely that many other technological civilizations had a chance to appear before us. Because in the earlier universe, life would have had a pretty hard time to emerge, let alone thrive, because it was such a hostile environment.
That's true. What they don't mention is that the universe was much smaller back then, so everything was more concentrated. As the universe is expanding, things have more space, and so a galaxy like the Milky Way has a lot more space to stay stable over time and not crash into some other giant structure or get impacted by a black hole. That doesn't mean that another civilization couldn't exist, but what it means is that if life was created somewhere, there is a higher risk that as it was growing, the planet got destroyed and it just stopped existing.
Our sun was born right at the end of this cosmic death show. The universe has never been more welcoming to life than it is now. So humanity has arrived at a very convenient spot in time. Life on these planets has an incredibly long time window to appear and pass the hard steps. Because if civilizations appear at random in the Milky Way within a time window of a trillion years, then very few, if any, would appear before today. Then a couple more arrive in this period of a billion years that we're in, before all star-faring civilizations that could ever exist emerge altogether. This weird tsunami-like distribution is the result of both the hard steps model and something else. A sort of deadline for any space-faring civilization.
This deadline that they are discussing and this evolution of new alien galaxies is correct. So what we do in science is create models to see or likely it is that something else is going to appear. It's unclear if we're ever going to reach a population size similar to the Foundation cycles or Star Wars movies. He's over the right that the longer time we have, the more likely we are to see a civilization with properties like the one of humanity, but that doesn't mean that humanity is still going to be living or that the other civilizations are still going to be living as well.
Why aren't aliens already on Earth? Humans are curious, expansionist, and hungry for energy. We've spread over the world and made it our own. Our technology has been improving over time, first slowly, then breathtakingly fast. If these things don't change drastically, and our descendants want to prosper, they will expand into space. We could construct a Dyson swarm for endless energy and transform planets into new homes. We could cross interstellar distances, allowing us to reach for planets around distant stars. If we have the motivation, we can become a galactic civilization.
That's just a side note, but I always find it kind of strange and borderline creepy how all of everything he's describing is with his cute little characters. He's talking about humanity developing and expanding as if it were all peachy and nice people. If you see the videos, it's nice people living in communities and breaking down a tree and making some cities that are green and nice. And it's not entirely the truth. We see with climate change, we are breaking down a lot of things and we have little regard for making sure our ecosystem is going to survive for 500,000 years until we can meet and fight these alien civilizations that are going to arrive.
Similarly, if loud civilizations were running around the galaxy in the past, terraforming planets or harvesting the energy of stars, they may have prevented our existence. Had aliens started colonizing Earth while we were still sludge in the oceans, that sludge would never have turned into humans. This is how loud aliens create a deadline for new civilizations appearing. Even if a loud civilization respects planets with naturally occurring life, and expands around them, like humans do with wildlife reserves, any civilization on such a planet would not be able to expand ever. Trapped forever on a tiny island.
I like how he's describing things that are good and bad, like we have wildlife reservation zones, which means that we are protecting our environment, but then that environment cannot grow out of it. Wildlife reservation zones are great, but they are not enough to protect our biodiversity because they are way too small and we have a lot of ecosystems that are bigger than just a wildlife reservation. I feel like the main point of this video seems to be that we have to colonize space because if we don't, there is a probability, according to our models, that some other civilization is going to do it, and that's bad. That's basically called imperialism.
Humanity is like this right now. We wouldn't be able to detect ourselves from the other side of the Milky Way. If they stay quiet forever, maybe because of their culture or abilities, then they are not really a concern for us. If we're not special and succeed anyway, then any other civilization with the motivation and resources to would eventually expand beyond its planet of origin. Okay, what are the consequences of all these assumptions and ideas? Grave consequences. Race to the stars. If we are really early, then eventually others will catch up with us. Civilizations will emerge all over the place. They, like us, will face an important decision. Do they stay quiet, take it easy, and tend to their planet for as long as possible, or do they start expanding to take a chunk of the galaxy before someone else arrives? Meeting others does not necessarily mean war or conflict.
I like how he say, meeting others doesn't necessarily mean war or conflict. No, it doesn't, as long as the other civilization you meet is like, fine, take everything you want, we're not gonna fight you for it. I see no way this can go wrong. The point where he's right and where we agree on it is that we have never seen any sign of human intelligence or alien intelligence anywhere in the universe. And scientists get excited every time they see some kind of signal that has some kind of periodicity or that doesn't seem random, but usually it's a pulsar or some kind of object emitting something with a nice rhythm. Even if we heard about such a civilization, it would probably be a very long time before we met them, and we might have time to react. Just like another alien civilization might have time to get ready and to fight back to protect their territory.
In the worst case, a civilization could be completely enveloped by the empires of others, eternally doomed to be a galactic backwater without control over their fate. So if we want a seat at the galactic adults table, we best get to work.
This feels like a promotional material for Elon Musk. You probably heard about the guy and his space stuff. But one journalist I heard that had a really compelling point was saying that Elon Musk keeps saying that we're going to save civilization if we can go to Mars, if we can give Wi-Fi to everybody. But he's not really doing things that are going to save civilization on the planet Earth. What he's doing is colonizing space. And it's a really smart move. He's occupying the sky around the planet Earth by launching thousands and thousands of satellites and objects. He's building spaceships that will let him, and as human, but mostly him, harvest precious minerals and materials from meteorites, or maybe the moon, or maybe Mars, as needed, because he's the one who will have the technology and the funds to get paid by investors to go and make them money by harvesting resources. It's a really smart business plan, but it's not about saving civilization. It's about finding a new world and colonizing it. And so the whole motion that we have now with a race to space and the grave consequences that he's talking about is not a move to ensure the survival of the human race over the next million years. It's a move to let a few people make a lot of money and do cool things and get glory.
We really are early, we have an incredible opportunity to mold thousands or even millions of planets according to our vision and dreams. And one day when we meet others, we can greet them and meet them as equals. Wouldn't that be nice?
I love how we are going to meet the others as equal, because you know what? Humans typically do that. And everybody is nice and cartoonish around the Milky Way. It's kind of funny how Kurzgesagt is a German word, and Germany has a recent history with occupying others and imposing our will, where they usually reflect about it. But it doesn't seem like the channel is worried at all about the effects of human terraforming other planets.
One day, when we meet others, we can greet them and meet them as equals. Wouldn't that be nice? Wait, what's this? We've finally received a signal from the Cosmic Pioneers crew that we lost contact with 10 years ago. Through a special imaging technique called illustration, we're able to reveal what happened to them and immortalize them in our very first drop collection.
I'm loving the product placement. Transition was very, very smooth. I'm both really fascinated by the video and the production quality, but I'm really creeped out about the message. This is basically a call to colonize the entire world and impose our domination as fast as possible. And apparently, there is no questions to be had about our motivations and the kind of leadership we are going to impose on others if we meet them.